What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing Kiwi System Log Server step-by-step process. So let's get right into it. Okay, so installing Kiwi System Log Server. So this is how I did it within my environment. Now, the first thing that we need to do is open up a firewall port. And for me, I feel like the best way is to create a group policy because then you could push it out to multiple machines, right? So within my Active Directory, I opened up the group policy management console. I went inside group policy objects. I right-clicked on it and then clicked on new. I gave it the following name. I clicked on OK. I located my new GPO. I right-clicked on it and I basically picked edit. Within here, I went inside computer configuration. I opened up the policies. Within here, I went inside Windows settings. Within Windows settings, I opened up the security settings. And within security settings, we need to go inside Windows Firewall and then just open up the Windows Firewall with advanced security. And we're going to select on inbound rule. We're going to right click on it and then pick on new rule. You're going to get the wizard. So we're going to pick on custom, click next here. From the programs, we are going to leave it as the default and then click next. For the protocol type, we're going to click on the drop down menu and we're going to pick on UDP. Local port, we're going to click on the drop down menu and we're going to specify the ports. And the only port that I am going to open up within my environment would be the following, which is 514. Or 514. Click next here. The scope, I'm going to leave it as the default. Click next. For the action, default, click next. Profile, default, click next. Now for the name, I'm going to give it the following and then click finish and then we're good to go. And just apply this particular GPO to the machines that you want your system log server to grab logs from, right? And then you're good to go. Now, next thing that we need to do is get a copy of the exe file. I dropped it on the desktop and I'm going to select it, right click on it and run it as an administrator. It is going to start prepping to start the installation. You're going to get this right here. So click on download and install this feature. It's going to start downloading the required files and you're going to get this. Ugh. Well, I got this. So I restarted the machine. I started the exe file again. It started downloading the required files. And then again, I received this problem. So I restarted the machine. And I said to myself, okay, something's going on with the exe. I re-downloaded the exe file. Still the same problem. So what I did was on my desktop, on my server, I clicked on the start menu. I typed in control panel. And within the control panel, I went inside programs and features. And on your left-hand side, I clicked on turn Windows features on and off. You are able to do it manually. So that's what I did. I clicked on it. I clicked on OK. I picked the option to let Windows Update download the files for me. It started downloading the required files. And still, I had this problem. I was like, what's going on? And I'm not doing this on the Windows server, so let me correct myself. This machine is a Windows 10 machine, and this is where I was having this particular problem, not on the Windows server side. So what I decided to do was mount the Windows ISO on this virtual machine, and I basically held the shift key and right-clicked on the ISO, which is the DVD. I clicked on Open PowerShell Windows here, and it opened up. And I ran the following command, okay? Now, this command, what it does is actually installing the .NET that we need. It's using the ISO as the primary source to grab the .NET installation files to install on the machine. So I hit enter. It started enabling the feature. Operation completed successfully. I restarted the machine. And I went back inside my desktop. I right-clicked on the exe. Run it as an administrator. It started prepping again. It bypassed the option or the requirement that you needed .NET framework. So that's the way I got around that. Again, I'm using Windows 10. I'm not using like a server edition because you are able to install Kiwi System Log Server on a Windows 10 machine. So why not? That's the reason why I'm doing it. So from here, let's click on I agree. You have two options. I picked the first option, which is the default one. So click next. You are able to assign a particular domain account to this service For my environment, I left it as the default as a local system account. So click next here. I definitely want to install the Kiwi system log web access as well as create new web access logging rules for the Kiwi system log server. So I left everything as the default and then just click next here. This is everything that's going to basically install. These are the components. Again, leave it alone and just click next. If you want to change the destination of where everything is going to be installed, you could change it here. By default, it's going to drop it inside the C drive. So click install. It's going to start installing. It's going to want you to install Visual C++ 2010. So just basically accept the license and terms and then click on install. It's going to start installing it. And once it's done, you're going to get this dialog box. So just click finish. It's going to want you to install Visual C++ 2013. So again, accept the license and terms and then click on install. It's going to start processing that. Once it's done, you're going to get this dialog box that it was successful. So just click on close. You are going to get a command prompt. So don't freak out if this shows up. This eventually is going to disappear and it's going to get to here. So you're going to click on next. These are all the prerequisites that you need. Just leave whatever's checked off, leave it alone because that's what you need. The rest, if you already have it installed and it's up and running, you don't need it. So just click on install. It's going to start installing what it needs. Once that's done, it is time to install the Kiwi system log web access. So click next here, accept the license and terms, click next here. Left everything as the default, click next. Again, you are able to redirect the installation files to somewhere else. By default, it's going to drop it on the C drive. So I left it as is. Click next here. You are able to change the ports. By default, it is 8088. And make sure that you have automatically configured web server exceptions with the Windows firewall. By default, it is checked off, but just make sure that it is, you know, checked. And if you want to redirect the website root folder, you are able to change it here. By default, again, it's going to drop it on the C drive. So click next here. Provide an administrative password for the web console. The requirements for the password is at least 15 characters, an uppercase, a number, and a symbol. Once you do all that stuff for the password, confirm it, and then click next. Install. It's going to start copying the new files, installing everything within the directory. Once it's completed, you're going to get this. And on the desktop, you're going to see a new icon, and that's good. So click finish. Click finish here. It's going to start running. And again, I'm running the eval version because I'm testing it out and because I want to see how it works, because at my 9-to-5 job, this is what we are actually using for our system log server. And the best way to do it is, you know, install it within your environment so you could test it and able to support it at your job. How cool is that? And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.